Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. The judge is in and court is in session, and this time it's with the brand new personal injury court. Let's take a look.
This man had one of his testicles destroyed at your place.
Actual cases.
Her car had come through and slammed me up against the toolbox.
There was a torpedo coming at my face.
Court TV's biggest lawsuit.
You are suing for $150,000, $155,000, $2 million.
Some of the biggest claims in TV history.
There was a cockroach in my ear. I could feel its little legs.
And Judge Gino, who tells it like it is.
Please welcome the latest judge to join the daytime court show lineup, Judge Gino Brogdon. Okay.
Hey.
How are you?
How you doing?
Doing well.
Can I hug y'all?
Oh, yes. Yes. Right.
We will have it no other way.
All right.
Not la cucaracha in the ear. No.
Wait a minute. Now, that courtroom is very busy. Yes. I just want to start by saying that. There's a cockroach situation. There's something happened with someone's testicles. They are very candid and, I mean, in your face, raw.
Now, we get up in there now.
I see. In more ways than one, but that's not my business. So how do you feel now? I mean, you've been doing this for a number of years,
yes.
But now the cameras are front and center in your courtroom. How does that feel?
Honestly, at first, it was scary as hell.
Uh-huh. Okay.
But I started thinking of it as personal injury court has a big jury called the American public.
Yes.
So it made me calm down, and then I got right into it because this kind of appeals to all my natural senses.
Yeah.
So tell us the premise of the show, and how does it differ from other court shows we see on television today?
The reason personal injury court is different is really a couple of levels. One, the nature of the cases. These are the most dramatic. They'll make you cry, they'll make you laugh, they'll make you gasp. These cases are ripped right from the headlines.
Wowzers.
Nationally, locally, state. They're based on real cases, and the litigants are, the people involved are exciting and interesting, and the team that put this together, from Barry Posnick at MGM, David Armour, who's the creator, all the way down. I've never worked with a team of people who love what they do, from executive producers all the way down to people that get you lunch.
Yes.
I like the people that get you lunch.
Right.
I got to tell you, personal injury is a big thing, a huge thing, and it's all about volume, but still being able to settle the cases in respect to your client and making sure you're getting the most for them. It brings out the best and the worst of people.
It does.
What has been some of the worst things that you've seen in your courtroom?
Well, the worst thing is people that'll file a lawsuit and bring it to court, and it's not a real lawsuit.
Oh.
You get that in any court system, and you get that on personal injury court. Money motivates people, but so does passion.
Mm.
You know, these cases involve passion and drama that appeals to the best of you, but for some people it brings out the worst.
Mm-hmm.
But that's how it reflects a real courtroom situation. You see the whole spectrum. And that's why I'm so excited about it.
Personal injury.
Ooh, personal injury. But speaking of personal, you are personal, you're the real deal. You sat on the trial bench for, 10 years?
Yes,
right here in Atlanta.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Atlanta. And there's one of the, Fulton County?
Yes,
one
ma'am.
Of the busiest courtrooms here in Georgia area. So how closely does this show imitate real life for you?
Very closely. In a courtroom where I sat, I dealt with everything from a plane crash to a quadruple murder case. All the elements are the same. All the human factors are the same. People want fairness. People want finality.
Mm-hmm.
People want certainty. And it's the same in both courtroom settings.
Yeah.
You got all the same emotions, all the same motivations. I mean, it's a mirror image in many respects.
Wow. Mm. So you're the youngest of 11.
Yes.
Oh, y'all was deep in the house, huh?
Yes.
Is that
11
what the 11 is for when you ring? Oh, that's super duper cute.
He has a Super Bowl win right
there.
Yes. I love that.
It's more of a tribute to my brothers and sisters because they raised me. You know, when you're in a big family, there are 11 of us in 11 years, 9 boys, 2 girls, 1 set of twins.
Wow.
So my parents were tough. But, you know, when you get down to the baby like me, it's the older kids that raise you. So I wear this ring to tribute to my 10 brothers and sisters.
That's really sweet. Very nice of you. Did you always know that you wanted to be a judge?
Did you know that? No. My parents' goal was to get me out of high school and get out of the house, right? But I met a lawyer when I was in college, and football sounded like being in a courtroom. Courtroom sounded like being in a, on a football field. Oh, wow. You just didn't get to tackle anybody in a courtroom. Yeah. Once I got into a courtroom as a trial lawyer, I saw what judges do, and I said, I can do that too.
Yeah, you can tackle in the courtroom.
Yeah, that's right.
You tackle with your argument.
Ain't that
exactly.
The truth?
Yeah,
ain't
you slap them down with a sentence. You know what I'm saying?
It just you sound like you've been there before.
Well, I should have been an attorney. I really should have been. I missed my calling, I think. But I found another one, so
there
it's okay.
Exactly. That's right. That's
exactly.
Right.
So you have children yourself.
I do.
Do any of them follow in your footsteps?
I've got two lawyers and a professional basketball player. I tried to talk them out of going into law school, but I'm really proud of all three of them.
Why would you talk them out of instead of talking them into it?
Because I think it's so important for young people to figure out what they want to do, to not look for a job, but look for a career. Mm-hmm. Look for something that makes your heart flutter. Mm-hmm. And don't follow me just because of money or prestige or whatever. If you want to be a school teacher and that makes your heart flutter, be the best school teacher you can be. So I kind of push them to go after your passion, go after your calling.
Mm-hmm. All right, scales on your cufflinks. That's gonna be my last name.
You don't miss nothing.
I don't. Well, we thank you for being here
today. Thank you so much.
And guess what, everybody? You can find Personal Injury Court because it debuts on Monday, September 16th. Go to personalinjurycourttv.com for listings.